I want to say a couple of things about why we're here. I was next door at Nan's breakfast, and they have established an award in my wife's name, my late wife, and they decided that I should be the first recipient of that award. Emily was from a little town of Monk's Corner. We met on South Carolina State's campus come March 15th, 60 years ago. I'll always remember that date because that was the first day that I was arrested. And I met her in jail on that day. About 18 months later, we were married. Stayed married for 58 years. We talked about this state that we love so much. I remember her telling me about her experiences, walking 2.5 miles to school every morning, 2.5 miles back home every afternoon. A little 22-acre farm. She learned how to drive in a pickup truck. She came to South Carolina State in that pickup truck with her luggage on the bed. How her father would walk from Monk's Corner to Somerville to work in the off-season, cutting pulpwood. We talked about what our parents sacrificed for us and what we owed to our children and all other children similarly situated. We often talked about the leadership of this country, and there's nobody who Emily loved as a leader in this country more than she loved Joe Biden. And we talked about Joe all the time. And so, as I was trying to make up my mind what I should do and when I should do it, I was informed that my accountant had passed away. And his funeral was last Friday in the rural part of Richland County. I went to the funeral. I got there about 30 minutes early. And I was walking around speaking to people, many of whom I had not seen in a long time. And I spoke to them, and there was an elderly lady in her upper 80s sitting on the front pew of the church, just a few seats away from the coffin. And she looked at me, and she beckoned to me. Didn't say a word, just beckoned. I went over to her. She says, "Lean down. I need to ask you a question." And I leaned down. And she said, "You don't have to say it out loud, but you just whisper into my ear, who are you going to vote for next Saturday? I've been waiting to hear from you. I need to hear from you. This community wants to hear from you." I decided then and there that I would not stay silent. Martin Luther King Jr., in his letter from Birmingham City Jail, wrote that he was coming to the conclusion that the people of ill will in our society was making a much better use of time than the people of goodwill. And he feared that we would regret, not just for the vitriolic words and deeds of bad people, but for the appalling silence of good people. The appalling silence of good people. I decided after that experience last Friday with that elderly constituent and my background experiences and studies of Martin Luther King Jr., that I would break my silence today. And I've been saying to the media, I've known for a long time where I'll go before, but I had not decided whether or not to share it with the public. But I want the public to know that I'm voting for Joe Biden. South Carolinians should be voting for Joe Biden, and here's why. There's billboards around this county. On that billboard's my pledge. A lot of people ask me, why do you do billboards? Because my late wife said to me, I don't care how many TV ads you run, I don't care how many radio ads you run, when you run for office, I want to see billboards. That's why I do billboards. And one of my colleagues came and says, this is the first time I've seen a political billboard with no picture on it. Why isn't your picture on the billboard? That's because it ain't about me.
That's right.
It's about the message on that billboard. Mm-hmm. And the message is simply this: making the greatness of this country accessible and affordable for all. We don't need to make this country great again. This country is great.
That's right.
That's not what our challenge is. Our challenge is making the greatness of this country accessible and affordable for all. If it's health care, is it accessible? Is it affordable? Education, is it accessible? Is it affordable? Housing, energy, making it accessible and affordable. And nobody with whom I've ever worked in public life is any more committed to that motto, that pledge that I have to my constituents, than Joe Biden. Joe Biden and I used to spend a lot of time doing TV stuff together. We got to know each other. I know Joe. We know Joe. But most importantly, Joe knows us.
That's right. That's right.
That's important. Everybody think about Brown v. Board of Education. It may have started here in South Carolina, but Brown v. Board of Education, 5 cases. One was from South Carolina, one was from Virginia, one was from District of Columbia, one was from Kansas, but the fifth case was from Delaware. We have discussed thoroughly Gephardt, the Gephardt case from Delaware, and the Briggs case from South Carolina. That's how well I know this man. I know his heart. I know who he is. I know what he is. I know where this country is. We are at an inflection point. On that day that I met Emily, I went to jail around 10 o'clock in the morning, and I was discharged from jail, bailed out around 5:30 in the evening. When I sat in jail that day, I wondered whether or not we were doing the right thing, but I was never fearful of the future. As I stand before you today, I am fearful for the future of this country. I'm fearful for my daughters and their future and their children and their children's future. This country is at an inflection point. It is time for us to restore this country's dignity, this country's respect. That is what is at stake this year. And I can think of no one better suited, better prepared. I can think of no one with the integrity, no one more committed to the fundamental principles that make this country what it is.
A consequential endorsement from the majority whip, James Clyburn, in South Carolina, ahead of the critical South Carolina primary, and it goes to his longtime friend, Joe Biden. Errol Lewis, with your thoughts.
There's the moment.
Yeah, as we look at the vice president here, thrilled, obviously, to get this endorsement, and we saw James Clyburn tweet, in South Carolina, we choose presidents.
Yes, and you don't halfway do it. James Clyburn going all in for Joe Biden in a really important way.